This is the preamble.
It's preamble time. Amble, amble, amble.
There's a lot of pre.
Oh, whoa. Pre what?
Preamble. Mm. Not what you thought I was going to say. No.
Pre-drinks?
Pre.
Prinks, 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 prinks.
Pre-cum.
Hello.
And.
Welcome.
To.
The.
Slap Duck.
Podcast.
My.
Name.
Is.
George.
Gessie.
With.
Luca.
Sheehan.
And.
Sully Iqbal, a.k.a. Ah. I'm very confused right now.
You can find us on all great podcasting streaming services.
Except
thank you to Sully for the thumbs up, saying that I did a good job.
Also, on Radio Haver, 6 p.m. GMT every Tuesday.
Luca, we need to talk about this.
I thought we were taking it in turns, guys. We're taking it in turns.
No.
George, should I tell them who this podcast is brought to them by?
Yeah, can I read the thing?
Yeah, man.
I'm going to read it all in this first bit.
Do it.
Could you give us the most epic voice you have?
Wait, no. You know what I'm going to do?
What?
Wait, guys, you think it's a bit weird? I think, like, that. I don't know, like, I feel like there should be some kind of service where you really want to show that you're, I don't know, like a bit of a geek?
You know what? I would appreciate that.
Yeah?
Thoroughly.
Maybe if there was like a...
A parcel. No. A box.
A geek box.
What?
What?
We should make that a thing.
Never heard of it.
No, we can't, because it's already a thing.
What?
Whoa.
I'm going to quickly read this summary.
Yeah.
I'm not very good at this.
Okay.
So here we go.
It's fine.
I'm going to do it in a nice voice.
It's fine, George. I can edit this so I can make more pauses.
Sick.
Go for it.
My Geek Box has established itself as a leading player of geek subscription boxes. Each month, customers will receive a different themed box which will be full of a variety of merchandise and geek gear, as well as a t-shirt.
Ooh.
Well, there you go. That's...
So you can go to the link in the description of this podcast and video on YouTube, and you can go straight to a deal that will give you buy one, get one free.
Free.
Perfect. Because it's in time for Christmas. You can keep one. Give it to someone else, the other one, and then it's like, oh, I got you something, but you already got yourself something, and you feel good about it.
It is a limited time offer.
So remember at the end of last week's episode, I was like, I'm going to bring the flavor.
You can bring some flavor.
I'm bringing more energy and
what
more flavor.
What is your flavor?
My flavor, I think at the moment, is like chocolate orange.
It's a decent flavor.
Oh, that is my Christmas
it's a
flavor.
Christmassy flavor.
That's a Christmassy
good,
thing.
It's pretty fucking good.
Freaking I do like a chocolate orange.
I had mulled cider not long ago. I've never had mulled cider before.
But it was a non-alcoholic.
I do like hot cider and mulled wine, warm mulled wine.
Mulled wine's good. I think we've had this conversation last year.
This is a Christmassy thing.
Yeah, we're doing well.
Tune in like a week or two's time.
Oh shit, this would be fucking December episode. First
this
December
This is going to be a December episode.
This is the
Damn.
December. We're on that countdown to Crimbo, baby.
Now we can listen to Christmas songs. Now it's allowed.
Fuck no.
It's allowed.
It's Christmas time at all.
Da-da-da-da. Oh, that's the final countdown. Oh, no.
I love Top Gun.
So I once again came to this lovely abode. With no topics.
Well, don't worry, because I did. And this is a cool one. I like this.
Luca
and I feel like
did.
We can go on for a while
should
on this
we,
one.
Should we get, like...
Cracking it.
I feel like you should get in the zone for this.
All right. Three,
in the
two...
Dangerous.
You know what, actually? I'm going to give you a little bit more work.
No,
I'm going to give you a bit more work.
Just
tell you a bit more work.
Fuck you, then. Do it. Do it.
Insert a cool little, like, a... kind of sound.
All right.
When we're getting in the zone. In 3, 2... One.
Oh, you feel that?
Oh, damn. Shit.
Jesus.
Bring it.
Put my bowels go.
Wow. Fucking sick.
That went brown note.
It's
okay.
Like when you go down on a swing and you're like, whoa.
I'll be honest.
I didn't know you were going
the wrong way. And you were going the other way.
You saved yourself with the swing there.
Fucking.
Oh, shit. I just realized.
You like swings, DM me.
That's so grim.
All right.
Oh, fuck.
Topic this week.
Cool.
So I read an article on New Scientist, and the headline is Humans Placed in Suspended Animation for the First Time.
Wow.
You know what?
What?
I'm not that smart. When you first said suspended animation to me, I was like, shit, we froze a dude in, like, air? It was like fucking like
a floating.
Like a David Blaine shit.
Yeah, so like in The Incredibles when Syndrome freezes them.
Mm.
That's what I thought.
All right.
I'm
Elastigirl?
Listen, if you're smart and you want to teach me
Mr.
things.
Mr. Incredible.
And you're
you guys
pretty,
got
you and you're
busy.
Pretty.
Yeah.
Wow.
Listen, Luca.
You're a thirsty, thirsty boy. You know?
I enjoy Gatorade.
That's Gatorade.
Anyway, let's swing it back to the scientific.
Yeah, all right. I'm going to read out a couple of little excerpts from this because it's like, it's literally futuristic shit.
Okay, go for it.
Do you like the future?
We all like the future. Come on. It should be kind of cool. All right. So doctors have placed humans in suspended animation for the first time as part of a trial in the US that aims to make it possible to fix traumatic injuries that would otherwise cause death.
Damn.
So it's at the University of Maryland School of Medicine, and the idea, well, okay, so what essentially they're doing is EPR involves rapidly cooling the person to around 10 to 15 degrees Celsius by replacing all of their blood with ice-cold saline.
Fuck.
The patient's brain activity almost completely stops. They are then disconnected from the cooling system, and their body, which would otherwise be classified as dead, is moved to an operating theater. The surgical team has 2 hours to fix the injuries before they are warmed up and the heart is restarted.
That's pretty fucking badass. That reminds me a lot of like Metal Gear Solid.
It is mad that they can
That's
do that now.
Said.
Like Raiden's blood is like saline, I think. It is saline, isn't it?
I believe so.
Yeah.
It's saline like white.
No, saline is normally just salt water.
Oh,
or like a salt water solution.
Oh, yeah. Shit, yeah.
It's like what you'd like clean wounds with and all that kind of stuff.
Oh,
or, like, you give someone a saline drip if they're dehydrated.
Ah, okay. Cool. So that's really fucking cool.
So they do this for the most part to, if someone comes to it with an acute trauma, such as a gunshot or a stab wound, and they go into like cardiac arrest, if they've only got like minutes to live kind of thing,
yeah,
they'll do this. So I think their statistic is when they're only minutes to operate with less than 5% chance that they would normally survive, they give this experiment a go.
Because
chances are they're going to be dead either way.
Yeah.
True.
And at this, in this kind of scenario, you can freeze the body. They're not going to bleed out. There's no more blood. You can fix a gunshot wound, fix a stab wound, I guess bring them back to life, reanimate them, and theoretically they can live. They're going to release the results from this trial in early 2020.
Mm.
So we don't actually know how many kind of have lived or not.
Yeah.
But if it's a good outlook, that's kind of crazy shit.
That's pretty mad.
I genuinely don't fully understand the process of them taking out the blood and putting the saline in.
Okay.
So if you're a smart person and like kind of understand that, email us at theslapdogpodcast@gmail.com and like explain it in like
explain like
not
I'm five.
Smart person.
No, there's a subreddit called Explain Like I'm Five. And that's exactly the idea. Is like taking like someone would say, "I don't really understand this," and someone who is like an expert would explain it like they're explaining it to a 5-year-old.
Yeah,
it's super easy
Do
to
that.
Understand. It's actually cool on subreddit.
It is pretty good.
But yeah, it's like off the back of this very futuristic, or at least up until now, very futuristic idea that we could do this. What other things from science fiction would you like, that you think could be possible, or would you like to become a reality?
I could kind of see where this was going.
I thought you could, yeah.
For me, it's, I'm waiting for the augmented Olympics.
Ooh.
That's what I'm waiting for. I'm waiting for people to opt out of having, like, biological flesh legs or whatever, and just getting, like, proper, like, jet fuel legs.
Yes.
So they can run, like, fast as shit.
Oh, so no, I know what you mean.
I'm like, oh my God, that's fucking cool.
Like, just kind of augmented human beings. Like, oh cool, I got a robot arm, I got a robot leg.
Yeah, that is the next step.
That,
as soon as, like,
is.
I mean,
but
people...
But like, they're already.
You know, yeah, like, prosthetics
in a very,
and stuff.
In a very rudimentary way, where they're already.
As soon as you can articulate a hand like it's your own, you're there.
Well, you can at the moment, but it takes
but
a lot of effort.
But not with, like, input lag.
Yeah, like if it's like, because I guess the idea that at the moment is they're not hooking straight up to nervous system, are they?
No,
oh, damn.
They're hooking like their sensors. There's lots of different ways that they're doing it, but a lot of them is kind of like
there's
the
ones
muscles
where it's like,
that
yeah, muscles
over.
That are there already. Because when you have like a phantom arm, you're still moving the muscles, even though you know, because you've had an arm your whole life. When you do that shit, it's like, oh, it registers everywhere. Yeah. So they've got like sensors around, so it kind of knows when it's you want to lift your arm up, like your forearm up, or you, like turn your hand or put your hand down, kind of thing.
Yeah.
It's really fascinating shit.
I remember, this is a good few years ago now, there was, I don't really watch many of them, but there was a TED talk that kind of caught my eye. I thought, fuck it, I'll give this a go. I had 20 minutes to spare. And it was about kind of on this topic of augmenting humans that have lost limbs.
Yeah.
And it was one of a ballet dancer who lost both her feet.
Oh,
fuck.
And they replaced both of her feet. And at the end of it, she came out and did a ballet performance.
Wait, what?
Wow.
With both robot feet.
But no feet. That's whoa. Fucking cool.
Yeah. And it was that sort of thing. I was like, all right, this isn't just like someone's walking again. This was like, had enough articulation to do something as graceful as ballet, as ballroom dancing, as that kind of stuff. It's like, it hit a point pretty quickly and quite far ago. But I think the difference between feet and hands are hands have far more dexterity to them.
Oh, yeah.
Like, you got your individual fingers.
Yeah.
That's
But with feet, there's a lot of balance control.
True. Yeah, which is, I think, where a lot of that kind of that tech lied, was kind of getting the balance down.
Yeah. It's fucking cool.
Would they ever make it so that... Would they ever make it so that when you replace a part of your body, they would, like, want to put, like, the nervous stuff in that? So, like, say you lost your hand and you put your hand back on and you had a replacement hand. I'm assuming replacement hand, you can't feel stuff. So if you burn that hand, you're not going to feel it.
Sure.
Do you think they would ever go so far as to be like, we have somehow neural, whatever stuff in your hand, so you get burnt and ouchy?
I've heard that they've done stuff like that already.
Yeah.
But
for pressure.
I think it was,
So they could like squeeze things up.
You can actually feel that you're feeling it due to your nerve endings.
Like it kind of, it sends back kind of resistance, so you know like how hard or soft something would be. So there's still like, I think that shit is super early on still.
Yeah, which I think is such a fucking mad thing. Like if you think about like, you can pick up anything and you know how much to grip it.
Yeah.
Like not to crush it unless you want to.
Yeah, instinctively we know that.
You just know.
Yeah.
It's just like, what the fuck?
It's that monkey brain.
And bananas come in their own skin. Did you know that?
Wait, what?
Did you know bananas have their own skin?
No.
Yeah, when you
open... you just grab banana.
No. You've been doing it wrong. No,
what?
You gotta like... You grab it in the middle, like you hold both ends. You
snap it, and
No.
What is happening
it's
here?
It's solid. It's not like a juice.
What?
It's not like an orange.
That's why you stand in it. You smush it up.
Suck it out. I want to walk like you.
Now you know it feels silly.
Well, banana. I don't like bananas.
What?
What is wrong with you?
I hate bananas.
What?
Bananas are like one of the best flavors.
Low tier.
Low tier.
Negative.
I think we're getting off of the technology side and going into this.
Fuck technology.
we're getting into this.
We could have the technology to do it like in the cartoons when they squeeze a banana and it goes.
I want to be able to do that one day.
Fucking,
that'd be fucking
I feel like if you snip the end of a banana just so it's poking out and you might be able to do it.
Nah, man.
But you got to get it just right. You know can't what? Be a too I long,
like
can't be too
we
short.
We went from life-saving technology to a banana comes out.
I mean, let's be real. Bananas are life-saving.
That potassium.
Listen, I'll tell you why bananas are weak source. Because most of our bananas are made from one genus of banana. So if that genus of banana gets an infection and they all die, about 99% of our bananas are all gone.
I mean,
so guess
well, that
what?
Sucks. That would be
bananas
sad.
Bananas are fucking shit, dude.
Wait, well, have you ever had fried plantain?
That's not a banana, though.
It fucking is a banana.
Plantain is
it's on the
is
plantain family.
Basically a banana.
But plantain is its own.
Yeah,
fruit,
it's a genus of banana.
But it's not a banana.
But it's a genus of banana.
But it's not banana.
Right. Apparently, you know banana flavoring.
Yeah.
That's part of a different genus of banana. So there was.
I don't eat any banana.
Oh, you're stuff. Such a dick.
But
I will only eat
banana milkshakes
to
the
past. If they are like, it's got spicy shit on them.
Spicy bananas.
Well, spicy plantain chips are quite really
oh,
nice.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. I was like...
Bananas, no.
Spicy banana?
The only that's banana I will ever eat will be the apple-flavored banana from Zoe 101.
That's a very niche product.
That's not even a product, mate. That's a reference. Very niche-ass reference, bro.
That's not real.
No, bro.
Are you fucking for real?
At Jamie what? Lee Spears.
Oh, God.
Want to be on the podcast?
How's your sister?
Wee.
You know, Britney Spears?
Yeah, man.
Yeah. Just in case no one understood that one.
I didn't get it.
See?
So.
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah, perfect.
Thank you for that.
But yeah, bananas. Wee.
So, you know when... Do you guys remember when Britney Spears, like, shaved her head and stuff?
I do, man. Yeah.
And it was like, whoa, why did she do that? Because we were like, what? 14 at the time.
Probably younger.
And we're like, whoa, why would she do that?
Damn.
That's bullshit. And then you get to her age and you're like,
I want to shave my head.
No, I can see that the pressure of life is.
You look in the
hard.
Mirror, it's like, what'd I look like without hair?
Not even that. I
just
think
it's
like
life.
Fuck.
And
life.
Do you know who didn't understand her?
You?
Her fans?
The fucking boomers. Okay, boomer.
Okay.
I hate this Step fucking off. Trend that's come out. Oh, I fucking hate it.
Why?
The okay boomer. Like, it's. I think there's certain people that just aren't using it.
Okay, Moomer.
Right. Oh, it's this kind of shit.
Do you know what it is?
You are Moomer.
It's annoying, man.
We're all millennials.
No.
Yeah,
no.
He's not. He's Gen Z.
You're Gen Z.
He's Gen Z.
You're a fucking Zoomer.
Yeah. He's one of those.
I saw a great depiction of okay, boomer. And it was like an old like concept art painting of a knight defending this woman who's having like tomatoes and stuff thrown at her. What the fuck?
What the shit?
Bitch.
My phone's...
Okay, Google's assistance has just started talking to us. Are you fucking kidding me?
Oh, my... Anyway...
All right. Hey, Siri.
What the fuck? Okay, anyway, as I was saying...
She respects our privacy.
As I was saying, it's like a knight shielding this woman from, like, tomatoes and stuff being, like...
Lobbed at her.
Yeah. And the people throwing the tomatoes are, like, baby boomers. And... Gen Z is shielding the millennial.
It's literally
like,
it.
And the shield says, okay, boomer. And we're like, being shielded by like all the bullshit.
It's literally it, because boomers they don't hate millennials, they hate Gen Zs. But they don't understand that they're different.
Yeah.
And like the millennials don't do anything about it. But the Gen Zs are like, fuck this shit.
Yeah.
Come at me, boomer. Like the Greta girl.
Oh, Greta Thunberg, yeah.
She's fucking, she's the leader of OK Boomer.
Oh, was she like, she didn't come up with the OK Boomer.
No, but
thing.
She would be the figurehead. She's fucking destroying all the boomers.
She's destroying
she's
them.
She's just coming out saying shit like,
yeah,
go for it. Honey.
How dare you? God, I'm actually sick of, when on my commute, boomer, on my commute in the mornings, I tend to like catch a glimpse of what people are reading in the paper.
Yeah.
I should really read the paper on my own, but I just see it vicariously through other people.
It's a bit more enjoyable over someone's shoulder, isn't it?
And I hate how like there was one in particular of how Greta Thunberg was being like depicted.
Mm.
And it's like this girl is like what, 16?
Yeah.
If that.
A bit,
so.
A 15, bit 16. That. 15, and they're like weirdly focusing on her sexuality and like I saw one today. It's like there's been this murder case or something,
mm-hmm.
and the like her like apparently she was very like sexually promiscuous.
Yeah,
it's like fuck off, man.
Yeah, I
that should not that should not come into it.
What bearing does that have?
It's called boomers, man.
Broomers.
It's the boomers. It's literally.
Are they the ones actually running the papers
yeah.
though?
Yeah,
because like there's generations between millennials and boomers.
Yeah, but it's
that are actually the ones writing.
Not a lot of them.
It's like the X.
Two
X.
Yeah, Generation X. Generation X are the 80s people.
I thought they were the wrestling team.
Not to be confused with D-Generation X.
There we go.
Da, 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 da.
I knew that would set him off.
That was fucking good. GG.
Degenerate into
but yeah,
new.
I get really annoyed at the depiction of young girls in the paper. It always tends to be about how they look and not the actual story.
Because it's usually
and I don't want to be like, you know, everyone be like, oh, George, you know.
White knight.
Yeah. Like, mm-hmm. It just fucks me off.
I think it's the way that certain papers, they use that tactic to belittle what they're saying.
Yeah, it really pisses me off.
I don't think that should be used. That none of that should take into account
it's because they
at all for
they don't
any
have real
person.
It's like a very American thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because when you got no fucking ground to stand on, so you go for like the lowest denominator fucking shit.
You go for the visual appearance rather than something substantial.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, nah. Man, her hair is short. What the fuck? What is she, dude? That's not a real woman.
Whoa.
Shit like that.
Yeah, it's fucking horse shit.
Yeah, I never understood that.
But, yeah, I don't know how this got derailed to this kind of talk.
Boomers suck.
Yeah, okay.
Because the Gen Z and the millennials got together.
Did we bang?
Well, I mean, the three of us.
That would
not us. No, not us three.
I'll be honest. I wouldn't.
Well, you know, the three of us.
Here at the Slapduck podcast, we don't promote relations between millennials and Gen Zs unless it's a Gen Z that is over the age of 18.
Yeah. I don't think that needed to be said.
Well,
mate.
You were kind of saying like, oh, the Gen Zs and the millennials.
You're
together.
Gen Z. Like, you're 22.
Yeah, but the majority of Gen Zs are younger than.
Are you actually Gen Z if you're 22? Yeah.
He's like the first year of it.
It like varies.
I'm gonna fucking look
this up. It depends because Wikipedia says 1996. I'm born in 97. Some places say 98.
Oh.
Some places say 95.
So you might be millennial.
I had cassette tapes. Mm-hmm. I had floppy disks.
Yeah,
but I also had. Don't remember a time where I never had the internet.
Wait, did you have a floppy disk or like the hard floppy disk?
Because
there's
the
difference.
Because
the original floppy disks were big and they were actually floppy.
No, it was like the.
No, legitimately. Well, like the little like disc
the little
ones.
Black squares.
Yeah, like, they look like floppy disks, and we call them floppy disks, but they weren't floppy disks.
I have no.
You boys
clue
ready
what
for
that
this?
Big one is.
Okay, I'll show you later.
Y'all so ready for this shit?
I don't have one. I'll show you online.
Yeah.
So we have the silent generation.
What are they?
Which is
silent movies.
1925 to 1945.
Silent movies.
Fucking losers.
So Great Depression, Dust Bowl, World War II.
What losers?
Dude.
I wouldn't, mate.
Learn.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't do that.
Learn how to put sounds.
I mean, yeah, maybe.
I'm all right with that.
Maybe,
listen,
yeah, maybe
the 20s. Leave it in, but I'm all right.
Yeah, maybe speak in the 20s, learn words.
I mean,
can we push past it?
20s were silent. Okay. And then we got boomers. Oh my God.
He's so Gen Z.
Yeah. So boomers are 1946 to 1963.
Damn.
So that's Vietnam, Woodstock, the Civil Rights Movement, President Kennedy's assassination, Watergate, and space.
Some of
that's a lot that happened.
Some
there.
Of that
fucking
stuff
loads.
Was cool. Civil rights,
that's
cool.
There's a lot there that was kind of cool. Some yes. shit.
Space race.
A lot of shit.
Debatable.
What?
I'll be honest.
Oh my God.
It's just a
point
okay. to make each other
so
too much.
So Gen X, which is 1964 to 1978.
Okay.
Yeah, they're all right.
The fall of the Berlin Wall, the Challenger disaster, AIDS, MTV, the Iranian hostage crisis.
How did AIDS slip into that?
Because that wasn't that around the time of Freddie Mercury.
When was that up until?
The AIDS
Public
epidemic.
Conscience.
Yeah.
When was that up until?
That was 1964 to 1978.
Okay.
The Berlin Wall fell in 89.
Oh, shit.
That's wrong.
They got it wrong.
Next.
And it says Millennials or Gen Y is 1979 to 1995.
Oh, so I'm on the cusp. I'm 94.
Yeah.
I don't know
I'm
how 95. Much I trust this.
You're 95.
Yeah.
I don't know how much I trust that, though.
See, this is just a picture from Google.
Oh, that's fine.
Well, that's then, a very credible source.
Well, and then Gen Z is from like the end of that to
and
now.
Gen Z is 1996 to 2010.
What's off 2010?
Fucking Generation Z. Dragon Ball Z kids.
Dragon, zombies.
Dragon Ball.
Dragon Ball Z. Amazing. Can we make that a thing?
What?
The Dragon Ball Z generation. Oh, fuck yeah. I'd be sick. You're, sorry.
Wouldn't they be the Super generation?
Oh, my God.
Or we could call them
the Dragon Ball. That's
they
it.
Could be the Kai generation, the next one. The Super generation.
I'm digging this. Luca has no idea what's going on.
I dig it up. Dig it in. Not a clue.
But, yeah, boomers suck.
I mean, not all boomers.
I mean, technically, like, my parents are on the cusp of boomer.
Really?
1960.
I thought they were. Your parents aren't
according to this.
That.
They're old as shit.
Oh, mate, my dad's a boomer.
But no, but that's sort of things like. Socially, they're not.
Yeah, exactly.
But because they're on the cusp of that. I mean, I feel like these, like, timelines.
Cusp doesn't count.
I mean.
Like with me, I'm like.
Well, we're on the cusp
yeah,
of
exactly.
millennial and
yeah.
Z. You're on the cusp of
Z
and millennial.
Exactly, yeah. So am I a Zoomer? Am I a Moomer? Who knows?
Are you a Zennial?
No.
That feels good.
Right now, we only use
Zennial.
We only
good.
Use variations of Boomer.
Zennial feels good.
Nah. But yeah, that's the Boomers. It's the Boomers and the X's.
I didn't realize that this episode of the podcast, the first episode in December, was to be about boomers.
Okay, no, neither did I. I feel like there's also this fucking this meme trend. By the time this comes out,
no,
already going to be over. No. It's only like a week.
TikTok is too powerful to ever let this die.
But also, TikTok has too little of an attention span.
Is it TikTok that controls the memes now?
Yeah.
Is it?
Do you think so?
Yeah.
What about like
Reddit?
I mean, I've never seen a proper meme from Reddit.
Is that like a?
No, it's. I mean, I think it's probably TikTok. And Twitter. Twitter gets the memes.
I probably find out about them on Reddit.
Find out about them on Twitter before Reddit users.
And I find out about
it's just because
before the Twitter users.
I want to quickly put a little nugget of Twitter. So you guys made me make a Twitter account. Fine. Yeah. Used it for a bit.
Yeah.
Fucking hell, it's annoying.
This is part of the life cycle, mate.
No,
it is.
All right.
No,
there are certain things. I was speaking to Sully about this before you came. And there are certain quality of life things that I don't understand why you can't turn on and off. I don't want to see what someone's liked.
Well, I do, because...
No, but...
Sully likes cool shit.
I would like to be able to turn that
Wrestling.
Off.
Wrestling?
Yeah, fair.
But you can't. I kind of care about what someone's retweeting, because essentially they're putting something out there. But just because they liked it doesn't mean it needs to fill up my feed. So it's just full of constant shit that I didn't subscribe to.
So do you get upset when you see, perfectly cut screams that I like? Or, anime things? Oh, you fuck.
But what about...
No, because I logged on and saw this and just saw likes.
It's part of the life cycle.
What about...
You will do this. No. You'll think, this is bullshit. And then...
Well, it is.
And then, a couple days later...
No, but it's also if you liked it enough, you'd just retweet it and that's fine. Yeah, cool. It would come up. I want to be able to turn off the... I don't care what someone's liked.
Yeah, but sometimes I don't retweet stuff I really love. So where I
then
didn't,
it's
I,
obviously not good enough to
no,
care about.
Because it doesn't fit the brand of my page.
The brand of your page.
That's a lie because
Page is wrestling and porn. I feel like everything you do
not
is
porn. There is no pornography.
Fuck off.
There is no pornography.
Mm-hmm.
It is wrestling and very attractive women.
Showing tits.
No. See, pornography, there's a line.
There's a line, is there?
There is a line.
All right, Instagram.
There is a line.
Free the nipple, motherfucker.
Listen, there's nothing wrong with people doing pornography.
Yeah.
But there is a line.
What is the line for you?
Well, one is pornography.
All right, what is the line for you?
Maybe when you're nude.
Right.
But when you're not nude.
All right, so what is nude for you?
Nude means
right, but so you could literally be covering up your nipples with some fucking tassels and a book covering your genitals.
That's
is that
not
nude?
Pornography.
Well, they're nudes.
There's a difference between naked and nude, though.
Is there?
Yeah, nude is when
fully exposed.
No, it's specific to a feeling. It's when you feel vulnerable for being naked. Where naked is a choice.
I'll be honest, I was not considering this.
No, you definitely were.
Although.
I think so. I think that's right.
You should follow me on Twitter at Sully_Iqbal if you want to see me retweeting fucking perfect moonsaults executed by Io Shirai.
Yeah.
Fucking they
actually
are.
Sick.
Yeah. See, this
gorgeous.
Is.
Gorgeous.
I'm not a fan of really any social media platform. There's no one that takes the crown as
TikTok.
For me, the best. But.
LinkedIn.
That is something that I'll give to Instagram is if I follow someone, I'm just getting their stuff. I'm not getting anything else.
Oh, I mixed up.
I like that. If people want to share stuff, they can share it through stories. And if I want to follow that, cool, I can follow that. But it doesn't come up as a feed.
Yeah.
And my feed, I want to be what I follow.
Mm. Yeah.
I'm happy to go out and explore, have the new section. I'll check the new section.
Yeah.
But if I'm scrolling through... And I get one tweet that you've actually done and a shit ton of likes and retweets from a bunch of other people.
Yeah.
I'm not going to see what you've actually done.
Yeah.
Because it's just getting lost in a sea of bullshit.
What if it's a perfect gif of, listen, you got the frame here.
Don't care.
There's Kona Reeves walking
into
the ring.
If I wanted that, I would follow
out
that.
Out of nowhere, out of the corner, you see Ricochet flying in, drop kicking him. And then Kona Reeves hits his head on the pole, knocked out. And Ricochet lands like a superhero.
If it's that good, at me in it. Done.
I always at you and shit, but you don't look at it because you don't use Twitter.
Because it's so full of
shit.
So
then it's a vicious cycle. So I at you, you don't look at it because you don't look at Twitter.
I want the option to
George
not
always
see
replies
things.
To when I at him.
I do.
If I would check for some other Twitter apps that aren't just Twitter's app.
Just use TweetDeck.
Isn't that not working anymore or something?
No,
like?
TweetDeck works. It's really good.
Because if I have the option in some of these to hide what people like and all that kind of stuff, then it might be more usable for me. Fine, I'll use it.
Kind of like Blue Alien.
Yeah, like how Blue Alien was before Reddit kind of bought it and shut it down. Damn. Same sort of idea. Because for me, like, it ruins that experience. I don't care if you liked a post on a cute dog. If I wanted to see cute dogs, I'd follow cute dogs.
You know what I think? I'm going to tip my hat in the ring now.
Bring Damn. It. I feel like this is needed because you were one of the reasons that I made this.
Cashing your money in the bank.
I've been thinking about this a lot, actually. I saying that I posted two pictures on Instagram over the past like 3 days.
I did see. They're lovely.
I see them.
Thank you.
I believe I love them.
Did a like.
Oh, hearted.
Good shit. They were art stuff. Mm. And the more I think about like social media, specifically where you're putting yourself out there, I hate it more and more.
Okay.
I like Facebook. I haven't used Facebook in fucking years.
No. Same.
I just have it because I use Messenger to talk to people.
Same. Yeah. And at this point, I don't even use Messenger to talk to people. I could nuke mine from space and it wouldn't change my life.
Well, there you go.
Oh my God.
Instagram, barely use it. Like I have it, like, you know, as a preface, I did use it for the past, you know, two posts, which was like two days apart.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't use it for anything else except to like look at art or look at what friends are doing.
Sure.
But I don't put myself out there anymore for like that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
So I feel like for me, like there are two types of people. There's the people that quietly observe and there are people who are vocal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm a quiet observer when it comes to social media. So I could easily probably get rid of everything and be like, this is fine.
And I'm super vocal on social media.
I'm very much in the middle when it comes to that. I'm not the most vocal on social media, but if I'm doing something that feels worthy of sharing, I will.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't just be like walking down the street and be like, oh, I'm gonna share that walking down the street.
Yeah,
it's,
like
it's not really my cup.
And it characterized it for me this morning.
Yeah.
Because I was walking to the tube from my house. And in the tube station, they've got this whiteboard that usually has like an inspirational quote or something. And I'm like, this is fucking lame. I really can't be asked to read this. But this woman stopped. Bear in mind, it's the fucking commute in the morning. So like there are people like chock-a-block going up.
Yeah.
She stopped to take a picture of it. And I was like, really?
Yeah.
Really? Like this bit. And obviously I have no say on what she gains from that.
Sure.
Like that could be like, her, like, you know, the greatest thing that happened to her that day is that quote, and I have no right to say that was fucking bullshit.
Yeah,
don't do it on the
or it could have been an in joke that she was meshing to a friend or some shit,
like, and that could have made her friend's day better.
Yeah,
and that's fine. Like, I think that's the good part of social media.
Yeah,
but I like in my morning mindset, I was like, really, you're gonna stop here and you're gonna take a photo of this for what reason? You're just holding everyone up so you can take a picture of this thing that you're going to forget about and not look at. Get the fuck out of my way. I'm trying to get to work.
You're a Londoner now.
Yeah, I know.
You're a Londoner
it's
now, mate.
Bullshit.
But do you know what you should
do? Birmingham's been burnt out of you living here.
You should follow all of us on Instagram and Twitter, and then you can judge for yourselves whether you think we're vocal or not vocal on social media. And then email the slapdogpodcast at slapdogpodcast@gmail.com. No, it's fine. They love us. They would do anything for us.
I'd do anything for a fan.
Yeah.
If someone said, like somebody that I don't know in my immediate vicinity who listens to the podcast, if they said, oh, I'm a really big fan, I was like, holy shit, like, what the fuck have I said over the past like
not let
year?
You take a
wait, so if someone messaged you like, I'm a really big fan, draw me something.
I'd be like, I'm not a service.
He said, here's my price list.
PayPal, man.
Literally, like, I had a guy DM, not even DM me, commented on a photo. Mm. He was like, do you do commissions? And I was like, oh, you know, I haven't thought about it in a while, but, you know, DM me and, well, we can talk about it.
Oh, that's cool.
I didn't receive anything.
Oh, cool. Nice.
It's just like a cold call with a real alluring question.
Yeah.
Dumb.
Do you want money? Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, well, I don't know about that. Yeah. Like,
no.
What do you mean?
So you're like, yeah, I give it away for free. You're like, oh, great, yeah, give me 12.
I don't think a fan would come up to me and say,
draw
me something. I'd be like, no, that's, I can take a selfie with you so you can share it with your friends who listen to the Slapdog podcast, and I'll hate you for it.
I would love.
I'm joking, obviously.
I would love for someone.
You stop me walking to do this shit.
I would absolutely adore if someone came up to us.
Oh yeah,
I don't know how they would recognize.
Yeah, I don't know how they'd recognize any of us.
I mean, no, we Photoshop stuff for our Instagrams.
But I don't think anyone would recognize me sober, because the only time I post something of myself is when I'm at drinking.
I don't know.
What have you done, Sully?
No, they might.
Yeah, they might do.
They might be a very big fan, or they might recognize our voices. We have very distinctive voices.
Maybe.
I feel like we actually do. I don't know. Listeners can tell us, but I feel like we sound different.
I used to Skype my I've got a very good friend who lives in Oxford, and I used to Skype her when I was at uni, and apparently she had my she had her like laptop open in her kitchen when she was in halls.
Yeah,
and she then told me later that like all of her housemates loved listening to my voice.
It is a nice voice.
I was like, what the
I do
fuck?
Like your voice.
Oh, thank you.
That's why we get you to reach it on it.
That's very kind. Really?
Yeah, it's nice.
Is there anything you want me to read?
Oh, mate. Yeah, I'll give you a book. You can make an audio book for me and then I can listen to the book.
Oh, could mate. You know what? That might be a New Year's thing.
You'll make an audio book for
me. No, I actually read.
Hey, you can read His Dark Materials and find out all about the Malefas.
Fucking sick. Are they like boomers?
Nah, man. They're like elephants/donkeys with wheels.
Like wheels for legs? The stare. No, but they got, the stare
they
he
got
just
two
gave
wheels
me.
And two legs.
That stare was just like, fucking serious?
Believe me.
Legs.
Believe it.
Lord Asriel, bit of a dick.
Mm.
Spoiler alert.
But you know what I really want to read? Not in preparation for, because I'll probably will watch this first and then I'll read it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's The Witcher.
I cannot wait.
When The Witcher comes out.
I feel like...
On the 20th or the 21st.
If you listen to this episode, I think we're 2.5 weeks away.
Yeah.
From it coming out. Comes out on the 20th of December. I've already said on this, and I'm saying it again, that is my Christmas binge.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Like the few days that I'm probably hungover from drinking around Christmas time and going with friends, that's my Witcher time.
Oh yeah, man. I'm so fucking excited for it. And I was thinking, like, if I really want to take reading seriously, because I don't read anything.
Oh, yeah.
And it's really bad. I feel like it's really bad for me.
But you consume it via, like, graphic novels, which is reading, but with an extra element.
Yeah, so maybe I'm a bit smarter than everyone else. That was a joke. But
George. Picture books.
That's what everyone else says.
Have you seen my collection of comics? I'm a fan as well.
I would really like to read the Witcher books.
Okay.
Like, what's his name? Andre Sikowski?
Something like that.
Andre didn't get no money for the games, Kowski.
But he's getting money for the show.
Yeah,
he's getting that, isn't he? So he's
royalties. And they've been renewed for a season 2 already.
Yeah.
Being filmed in the UK. Fucking sick.
Fuck me, yes.
Royalty. Maybe I'll get to meet Henry Cavill in Bath.
Royalty and royalty in a bath or in the
place? Oh my God, yeah, that'd be amazing.
He is a
proper Witcher
boy.
Star. Love that so much. Boy.
He is a big guy.
He's a
Amazon also have greenlit a second season for Lord of the Rings.
Yeah.
They're putting $1 billion behind five seasons of that.
Like season 1 being on hiatus or something.
Yeah.
I did not read the entire article.
You read the headline, didn't you?
I read the headline.
Fuck's sake.
Listen, Boomer, I don't have time.
You have more than enough time.
Your
work.
Listen, okay, I work really hard. I genuinely work hard sometimes.
So if you can't convince yourself, you're not convince anyone else.
Hey, wait. Let's just be real. Nobody is 100% at all times at work.
No, you can't be. There's no way.
There's no way.
Unless and you plus, love your job.
And your phone is so readily available.
I take it out of my pocket, I plug it into the computer, and I flip the screen down so it like stays as far away from me as possible.
That's a lie.
But it's, no, that's legitimately what I have to do.
But it's there. And it's
there and it calls you, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's like what if someone messaged
it's
me?
It's like, oh, I wonder what cool shit's on Twitter right now.
Like,
that's another reason I'm not... Anyone, Twitter, because I don't want that urge to be just checking Twitter.
Like it's TikTok?
I don't have TikTok still.
No, I don't.
But the Slapdog Podcast has TikTok, so you should follow us at the Slapdog Podcast on TikTok.
Why should I get it?
Yeah, what is... You have 30 seconds to sell TikTok to us.
Okay,
okay. I feel like this has been done before.
Can I do 30 seconds each?
You know
what? Okay,
because I want to appeal to each of you separately.
All right, well, you're going to get a timer, so just wait.
Bars. All right. While he's waiting, shall we do an improv?
Wait, no, improv. You ready?
No, okay.
I know. 3, 2, 1, beep.
Okay, for George, so you said that Twitter gets the memes, but guess where Twitter's increasingly getting their memes from? TikTok. You know, you've been seeing people retweeting TikToks on Twitter, and they're blowing up on Twitter, but they've already blown up on TikTok. So you can get ahead of the curve on those memes, my son. And also, on TikTok, you can find some cool stuff. There are people making some really interesting, like, not just memes, but, like, production stuff and art from there for yourself.
It's not a bad shout. Do you like art? Do you like it? Oh, you got
good timing.
Now, time for young Luca.
Yeah, now, I feel like this is going to be the hard one for you.
Also, everyone, just right now, pause this and go and Google Nuka, N-U-K-A. From The Lion King 2.
Looks nothing like me, but he keeps overlaying my face on top of it.
And if you overlay his face over Luca's, it's like the same person.
You know what? Don't even bother doing that. Just check the Instagram. Sally,
go to the Instagram. I'll post it.
And you can vote.
Okay.
Do like a little poll thing. All right. 3, 2, 1.
Oh, shit. Oh, sorry.
Yeah, you know what?
Go for it.
For you. Okay. Two things.
Yeah.
One, there were so many people making things about how to cook cool stuff really well.
All right.
Okay, in bite-sized chunks, so it's easily consumable. Also, there's a lot of stuff on music production, especially there's a guy who does like folio work on there. Ooh. And also, it keeps you up to date with the goings-on in the world, both with media and the news. The Washington Post are on there.
Really? Damn.
Mm.
You want to cook good?
I feel like you started TikTok strong and then just kind of like floundered in the end.
The news?
What if I'm getting the news from TikTok? Why the fuck am I getting the news from TikTok?
I barely get the news from anywhere else. I get the news from looking over people's shoulders on the tube.
I get the news from the Apple News app. I actually use the Apple News app.
You have Apple News Plus?
Yeah. No, fuck that.
Yeah.
I just don't really read magazines, and that's what Apple News Plus is magazines.
£7 for magazines.
Isn't it Fiverr? It's like a fiver a month, and you get I mean, if you're into reading digital magazines, you get an amazing money's worth from it. But I'm really not into that at the moment.
People read magazines.
My mom does.
The only magazines I really see are like Vogue and GQ. Was it CQ?
It was like Total Film, Empire, that kind of stuff as well. It's all on there. Men's Health, that shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so like, I feel like if you read a couple of them, it's a really cheap way of doing it. But
yeah, suppose.
I don't, so I'm not really.
I read Men's Health.
It's kind of like.
Boys.
I don't know about you guys, but have you guys got any of those almost like a rolling card for like Odeon or...
Yeah, I got one. We got Cinema World. Unlimited use Cinema.
How much is it?
17 a month?
Yeah.
£17 a month. And what does that equate to? Like, how many
in
films?
London, a cinema ticket.
Really?
I go to the O2 one, which is the Cinema World closest to me. That's like the nicest.
So the one in Canary Wharf?
No, it's the one in the O2 Arena.
That
is also pretty close to it. And I've gone to that one a few times.
Mm.
I believe a ticket there ranges between 13 and 16 quid for
fucking
one ticket.
Bullshit.
So if I go see two movies,
chips,
I'm all good.
Yeah, yeah. So you've got to cap out at two films a month, really.
Easily. Yeah. It's easy.
Where I live, it's two or three.
Pounds?
Two or three.
Movies.
Movies. Oh, I see. Okay.
So it's a little bit less affordable for me, because like sometimes a movie doesn't come out in a month I want to watch, so then it's how I pay £17 and watch a movie.
Yeah,
but sometimes I'll go watch three or four movies in a month and then it makes up for it.
Oh, I had a week off from work. I went to the cinema three times.
And you were
twice on my own.
Yeah. Do you like doing that?
Yeah, I started doing that when I was at university. Parents got me one of these cards when my first year of university.
Yeah.
And second, because first year I was out with friends. Second year, you're doing that less.
Yeah.
And because I commuted to university, I would go home via the Jubilee line rather than the Central line and just stop off at the O2. I would literally walk in and I would just see what was on. I'd watch a movie. I pretty much saw everything that came out that year.
Fucking great.
Just because, and like some things were good, some things were bad. If I really liked a movie, I was like, this is great. I'm going to bring a friend to it. I'd bring a friend along. Mm. I wouldn't have to pay for it to see it again.
Yeah.
Because you see it as many times as you want.
That's a good idea.
So for me, as someone that I want to support cinema, but in a way that is affordable, I feel like that's the most affordable way that I can support cinema at the moment is by having that.
Yeah.
And even if I only see one movie in a month and I don't really top out at it, at least I'm supporting a cinema like franchise from keeping open, because the margins in them are super, super slim.
At Cineworld, sponsor us.
Oh my fucking God, yes.
I would love that. That
put
would
be, me in a Cineworld advert.
That would be mint.
Like, my favorite place, one of my favorite places in London is the O2 Cineworld, specifically their super screen. Mm. It was like...
Is that where we went on our date?
Yeah, I think so.
You guys went on a date?
Yeah, we went to see a movie before going out with everyone because we had some like Time to Kill.
Oh, yeah.
And it's a massive screen. It's 4K, it's Dolby Atmos in there. It's absolutely giant.
Dolby
Atmos. And it's like the cutting edge of cinema without being gimmicky. Like, there's no moving seats. There's no 4DX bullshit.
I'm a
it's
big
just
fan of 4DX. Oh, 4DX. I don't know. I've never been there.
And it's just
or done it.
It's just cinema at its kind of, for me at least, the peak that I want it to be at. And it, like I will, if there's a movie playing there, I will fucking go to it every time.
Can I ask you guys a question?
Do it.
I don't know how much time we've got left.
This can be like the wrap up, but
okay,
it's cool.
So you can answer this at your leisure then.
Okay.
Have you guys got like a really big goal that you want to achieve
in life?
Or kind of,
sort of. Like, yeah, do.
Because I was when you were saying that, and you were saying like, you know, your cinema ticket and stuff. Mm. I don't know why my brain kind of went like, oh, you could kind of like build a cool community around that.
Yeah.
Or like, oh. I would like to maybe...
Well, link up with other members and just...
Yeah, but for me, it was more like, how do I make more of a... Because, weirdly, moving here, and I've tried to look it up, but I can't seem to find anything. But, like, I'm trying to look for, like, a fighting game community in London, and I don't think there is one.
There's definitely some.
There is definitely some. I mean, yeah. I know there's arcades and stuff in Croydon, but I don't particularly want to go to Croydon.
So with that, I'll go to places like... The loading bars that are scattered around.
Oh, yeah,
London.
Of course.
They're always doing like, they're always putting on things, or you can just go down there and they have all the different fighting games there. So if you're there, chances are there's a bunch of people there that are into fighting games.
Okay, I might do that more then. Because I was like, can I make a community myself?
Yeah, there's a website called Meetup, I think.
Yes.
Yeah, I've got it. And I was just like, oh, that's what I was looking through mainly.
Mm. I did that when I moved to London.
Did you?
Yeah,
did it work for
friends.
You?
Yeah, I made a few friends.
Oh, okay.
I left London, so
might do that more.
But yeah, there are like, I think if there's any, if you're in something, chances are there's other people that are into it.
Yeah.
And even if you're the other side of the same city, you can link up because of the internet.
Yeah, it's exactly.
So what's your, very quickly, your goal?
My goal, I know, I want to get to a point where I get to at least work on one movie that is like shown in the cinemas.
Nice.
That's what
you
I'd like.
You want a credit.
Yeah, I'd like to be able to go to the cinema and be like, I fucking did that. Like audio wise, or even just be part of that, a team that got something that I'm proud of to like the big screen.
Yeah, that's a good shout. Yeah.
I'm not shooting for like the fucking star. I don't want to be like top billing on something. I'm not an actor. I'm not going to be doing any of that shit anyway. But just being part of that team, being part of the sound team or something, that'd be incredible.
I'm kind of the, I want to go to the top.
Go on then.
I want to create so many things. That
President
like
Iqbal.
The best. I'll go into politics someday. Someday I'll do it. I want to make a fucking killer production company. I want to start a killer wrestling promotion. I want to make stuff. That's my biggest goal.
Yeah.
But I do also, part of me is like, I want to be fucking killer at it. I want to.
You want to excel at something.
Yeah, so indispensable at what you do.
Yeah, man, I want a fucking statue.
I feel like most people with statues get it torn down at
some
point.
That's fine. They can tear it down.
In recent history.
They can tear it down eventually. But
it's not really
a
good sign, is it, having a statue of yourself?
Nah, Gary Lineker's got a statue.
Has he? Wait till that Walker's money ends up. We don't know what's going
to
happen.
Oh, shit. Walker's
money.
Saul Campbell.
Yeah. Gandhi's got one. I want one.
Yeah. There's that really cute dog in Japan that's got a statue.
Damn.
I think you just cheapened the idea of a statue.
You can get fucked because this dog, I think this dog's owner died and he would wait at the same spot every day for him to come back.
It's super sad.
Super sad, but he then became like a name in the town because he'd always wait there and everybody walking past would always like
pet the dog,
you know, almost like, no, it's okay, you're fine kind of thing. And then when that dog died, unfortunately, And they made a statue of him. So he's
right there.
Immortalized, yeah. So it's like...
That is kind of cute. Yeah, man. I feel a bit bad saying you cheapened it.
Oh, there you go. It's a bit more lovely, I think.
It's a little bit more lovely.
Yeah. Also, there's a park in Japan where they have built the memorial to the Hokages.
Yes, they have. All six of them. Have you ever watched a series called Naruto?
Who's your favorite Hokage?
So where can we find us, Sally?
You can find us on everywhere you find good podcasts, except SoundCloud. And you can also find us in the tea leaves of the Hidden Tea Village.
It's very true. Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Do you remember the Hidden Tea Village?
Is that called Radio Hover? Every Tuesday, 6 p.m. GMT.
Yeah.
I remember that. Yeah, it's great.
But also you can find us in the Leaf Village. Not in the Sound Village, though. We don't associate with the Sound Ninjas.
No.
They're not great.
Pricks.
If you still listen to this and haven't been pushed away by the rest of our shit, last episode of this year, / beginning of next year, we're going to do kind of a look back on the past decade of the world.
Cool shit.
Things that we like, how the world's gone. If you want to be part of it, you want to throw something lovely out there into the world, please email us at slapduckpodcast@gmail.com. We will read them all out. We're going to make a little thing out of it. Please, anyone out there that wants to be part of it, don't be scared. Write in.
We'll even shout you out if you've got some cool shit yourself.
Yeah, if you want to shout out, we'll shout out.
Fuck yeah, that'd be sick.
There's some listeners that might like it.
We got at least 2K fans.
Boom.
We're talking about the fans of the 2K games.
Oh, I feel like there's less fans of that nowadays. Especially how this year went.
So, thank you for listening. And we're now going to go create our own statue of our favorite Hokage Uzumaki Naruto.
I mean, really, it's Minato. Minato is the best. I mean,
bye, guys.
Best Kakashi.
I mean, because he's Kakashi, but Minato is easily the best.
Yeah, I suppose.
He was the fucking Yellow Flash boy.
True.
I've already cut this part of the episode.
No, you haven't.
This is going to be post.
Rock Lee for
no one listens.
Hokage.
Rock Lee for.